Ruth here, and I have finally got all of what's in this bag. So I'd get my brother to get me most of them, though I did miss 5, so I bought them on eBay. But here they are. It is these. As you can see, there is slightly a bit more than the US version. There is a total of 16 and 12 cards, so I shall pull them all out. Show you the Happy Meal box. I did fold it because I'm going to cut it up. So let's move this up. You see, this is the Happy Meal box. There's obviously more to it. Here's the other side. But anyway, I guess I could put the box in the back there. So the seller I bought from on eBay made sure I had the Diglett one that I was still missing. So let's just open this up so I can sleeve it properly. It's nice that some of them actually have the cardboard at the back. Some of them don't, obviously. Yes, just to see it better. It's a very nice and different type of hollow effect. Rainbowy too, so it's nice. This is number 9 of 12. So let's just quickly put it in the sleeve. KMC perfect fit here. Just put this off to the side. And let's do this. Oh, not that it really matters, but I did buy this separately. This is completely different, but considering I don't really buy Crimson Invasion things. So I bought that separately because I wanted the Lowen Marowak. And it's in the random cards that my brother let me have. So just a brief randomness. I think this picture of Cloyster is much cooler than the other one. But, and he gave this one to me too. Anyway. Sleeves that. So as you know, by now I use these on at least some of the holographic ones. Okay. And here I had this one sort of open because I wanted to trade a friend some of the cards she had doubles of. So I'd have hopefully no doubles. But here are all of them, as you can see. There's Pikachu, Totodile, Fennekin, Scraggy, Squirtle, Shiny Magikarp, Snivy, Eevee, Rowlet, Popplio, Litten, Meowth, Piplup, Psyduck, Torchic, and Dedenne. So quite a lot more. And also on the back of these, they actually show you how to work. And there, let's see, it's printed in China. The paper, anyway. But, first of all, here are some of the cards. Here's the Pikachu. Peck, Crabrawler. So that was 7, 11, 5. And here is a number 1, which is the Rowlet. So I'm just quickly put him in the sleeve so I don't forget, because I don't really want to forget. So I keep all my things in good condition. I try anyway. So, as you can see, this is different than the US version, since there is more, but also there is no Solgaleo or Nora, which is unfortunate, because I mean they're legendaries, and who'd not want to have legendaries in their figure collection. So I guess the legendaries did pop up as, you know, figures for when you pre-ordered the game or something. So that's not too bad. Well, I don't mind too much. It's just bigger than the one I have, and it lights up. So I'm not too bothered. But it would have been cool to have as a huge figure. Those two. Anyway, finished sleeving up for now. So here, each one has a tear here, open, little perforated dotted line. And it's good because I was planning on keeping this, you know, silhouette. See? Doesn't that look nice? I was gonna stick it in my book because I stick weird things in my book, yeah? Okay, so this one is slightly dirty. Not very well done, this one. I guess I can color over it in permanent marker. Slightly disappointing. This one, you press this, and it opens. And look at it, it's got some green. It's like it's molding or something. But I'll see if I can color over it or something to fix it. Okay. And it can stand up on itself, if you see down here. But I'll clear up some more space before I show you all of them in the line. So that's Piplup done. Here, let's do Dedenne. And let's find that tear bit. I'm sitting awkwardly, so forgive me for not doing everything in front of the camera. I need to really work out a better thing for this, but I'm doing it on the floor, so there we go. There's that one. It's very cute, mousy type of thingy. And here, it just says shows that the tail moves, so I wonder what it does. But first of all, I will snippy sniff and show you what the card is. And this is number 6 out of 12. So I just get the sleeve and put it in the sleeve. And it is Nebby Cosmog. Okay. Well, it comes like this. So I'm guessing you can just bend it. So, like, there we go. Not a very much of a, it's a bit of a stiff bend, but it still bends. I won't do anything more elaborate, but okay. That's one of the most boring bends I've ever seen. Okay, so Next one. Pop, pop. Ooh, we have Eevee. Look at that. So that's ripped open. Okay, so by the looks of this, you twitch the tail and the ears move up and down. Okay. Let's have a whack at it. Okay, here is the silhouette. Very nice, if you can actually see it. There we go. Let's put it away. Right. And the card, if I don't drop it. Doing well so far, most of them had a cardboard thing at the back. And so we leave it up. And here is number 10 out of 12. Cutiefly. Cutiefly. Just the yellow thing. Okay, so here it is, end of the tail. Okay. Feels a bit loose. It's twitching. Okay. Well, that was strange. Alright, slightly more amusing. Here is Scraggy. Now, where is that? There it is. I prefer to rip it closer to me so I don't ruin it or anything. And here we have a bended slightly. I can easily put it under the dictionary. I mean, for some reason I have a couple in my bookshelf. Here is a bended because it has no cardboard. A number 4 out of 12, Popplio. And the card slightly ruined, unfortunately. But hopefully it won't be too bad. Hopefully I might get a double from the ones I bought from eBay. Because I couldn't actually see the cards. Because as you see, there is a slight ding. So hopefully I can get a double of that. So, by the looks of it, I press down and it's supposed to shoot up. We shall see. Anyway, here is the silhouette. Oh, Scraggy. I thought they were in different colors. Okay, so here he is in all his weird glory. So, okay. So then, boing, boing. Okay, so like a jack-o'-lantern. Okay, that would be freaky to wake up to, I mean, right. Alright, okay, enough fun with that. Here we have Meowth. And let's see what thing comes in and how this thing works. Oh, great, we got a mini Trump. Everybody wants a mini Trump, don't they? Trump Jr. Ta-da! I wish they didn't make one of him, but there we go. It's number 12 of 12. And this guy, oh, it's quite similar to Eevee. You move the tail and the arms move. Maybe. No, it's, I guess, just means, oh, the arms can move, but the tail can bend. That's it. I was wondering. Because the arms can move up and down. Same with this one. Keep that one. Then this one can move side to side too, but it's supposedly supposed to. There you go. Bit of a stiff bend there. Same with the other one, but there we go. Next, we have a Totodile. Sorry for going super slow. It's already like 16 minutes. Okay, so here we have a number 2 of 12, which is a Grubbin. Yes, and here is the silhouette on the bag. Oh yes, I never showed you the silhouette of the Mia, did I? There you go. And this one, it looks like you touch the scales on the back and the mouth goes up and down. Okay, so the mouth is open already, so I'm guessing chomp, chomp, chomp. Like a nutcracker. Okay. Moving on. That's actually pretty amusing. Okay, so let's go for Psyduck. This is one of the ones that I got from eBay. So, here is the silhouette thing. You know, I would have thought they would have done Psyduck in blue. I guess you can have only so many shades of blue. I mean, they did a Rowlet bag in blue, and a Snivy in blue when it's a grass Pokemon. So, there we go. So, you press the tail and the arms move, if I'm correct. And here we have another one of these. A mini Trump. Trump Jr. Guy with big teeth and very distinctive hair. So our first double. They only did one shiny. Or at least the silhouette color makes sense. There you go. And here we have number 10. Of 12, double. So here, I'm not really sure. Oh, it's a. There's a rolly thing at the bottom, and the fin moves when you roll it across. So, let's move the camera down a bit. Keep it on the tail. It doesn't really move that much. Let's, slightly. More of a moving when you go forward than backwards. Okay. So it doesn't really do much. It's not very top-notch quality though. You need to be wary of their paint job next time, I believe. Go for Fennekin. Okay, this one. It seems if you move the tail, the head moves. And let's see what card came with this one. Luckily, it had a cardboard backing. And it is number 3 of 12, Litten. There you go. Okay, the, for some reason, the silhouette is turquoise for a fire Pokemon. I'm not sure if it's turquoise, but it's something. It looks like that mini dog thing off Zootopia, though. Right. So here it is. Slightly creepy, if you... It's a fire Pokemon. Well, you gotta love their consistency. Right, so, their silhouette is this. And I have no idea what that means. It just looks like it vibrates or something. Not sure what it does. Oh! It's a bobblehead thing. That's cool. Paint job still needs to do a better work on it though. And it does wobble like that anyway, doesn't it? Well, I'm amused easily, so that's good. Let's keep it in the back. Okay, so this card, I have no idea what it is, because they actually came like this. So, we shall find out together. It is... Twing! Yay! It's a straight Popplio. Just what I needed. Let's keep it in the sleeve. And it's not dinged up or nothing, just slightly bent at the bottom, but still, it is a straight one. So that's good. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left. And here we have a black silhouette on it, which is good for Litten because it goes with Litten, really. This is a black and red cat-like thing. So, anyway, what you have here? We've got a Litten with a Litten. And it's sealed in the back, which is very unusual. They don't let me seal them in its own bag. And as you see, you shoot it. Very nice, though. Number 3, 2, 12, I mean. Can't count, really. Okay, that's probably, that's a double anyway. But here is the silhouette. Now I'm definitely keeping the eye on the camera since it has the battery light flashing. But it should not, like, die too soon. But here is the silhouette thing, as I said. Very good, suits the black bit. So here we go. And you put it in. I guess this way. Is it this way? No. Oh, there you go. We need the click. So these pop up, so I can do it. Maybe. Man, my thumb's not good. Oops! There it goes. So you do it until you hear click, then shoot it off. There you go. Did you see that? Okay, this one more time, then I'll stop getting distracted. Okay, last time. Alright, so, I'll just put this back in. Have him sit there. Put this back. And jiggle that again. Now let's go for Snivy. In the blue, when it's a grass Pokemon. That is so makes sense. Alright, I'm back since the battery died. And here we have Snivy, so it moves its arms if you go forward, I'm guessing. That's my total guess. So we have another Cutiefly. I don't know what to do with this one. Let's give away or something else, I'm not sure. Oh, I'll think of it by the end of this, maybe. Snivy silhouette. And don't forget, I do have that other giveaway. That's, what's it called? The code card. 300 sub giveaway, then there's the game codes, giveaway, legendary thing giveaway. Yeah. Okay, so we like what they do when they're running too fast in the anime. Okay. We'll go for Pikachu next. And this one, I have no idea what the card is, so we shall see. I'm guessing it moves. I'm not sure. So, we shall see what card it is, because I have no idea. And the card is... a Litten! So, at least this is like our at least second straight one. The other one is bent slightly. That's why. Okay. So here we have Pikachu's silhouette thing. It's nice and silhouette. Go with his cheeks. There we have it. I don't know why they chose to twitch the ears. Here, we have to press the brown part of his tip. I don't know why they went for twitchy ears. But there we go. And now we have Squirtle. Here, yes, a Squirtle that squirts. I don't have any water on me, and I'm not getting my playmat wet for this, so you know it squirts. I'm going to have so much fun amusing myself with this. But how does it squirt? Oh, there. There is a button, main part of the shell on its back. It squirts that way. And the card, which comes like that, is Grubbin. That's nice. At least I know it's completely straight. And that's our second one. Anyway, so our Squirtle silhouette thing is right here. You can see him too. Anyway, and one of the, I believe, I can't remember what's the name, but into the custom cards that I've seen on Leon Hearts and Unlisted Leafs channel. And he did like some cards with the space design, like silhouettes, and a picture of the Pokemon inside the silhouette with a random scene from the anime. Those were pretty cool custom cards. Anyway, here we have Rowlet and Popplio. So let's do Popplio first. Why not? But I mean, I can't see the card. And obviously, as you know, it is also a squirting one. Because you have Plunger. Boing. Two. There. As I said. Okay, so what's this card going to be? Because it is backwards. Boing. A Rowlet with the Popplio toy. That's totally type opposites. But there we go. Okay, and we're coming to a close. This last one now. This is the Popplio silhouette, by the way. And the last. Happy Meal. Here is Z Rabbit. And they stuck this in a bag instead of any cardboard or nightmare. So yeah, this one, as you can see, is a hoppity one. Hop hop. And we've got the Alolan Meow. 8 of 12. So let me just do a quick count to make sure I got them all. I'm pretty sure I have them all. But just to make sure, like, you know. Okay, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. That was 5, 6, 7. I have 2 cutie flies, 2 yoders, 1 duplicate. So I have 1 set at least and a couple doubles. Let's see. I keep 2. And if I have more than that. Okay. So all together. There's Rowlet, Grubbin, Litten, Popplio, Pikachu, Cosmo, Crabrawler, Meowth, Diglett, Cutiefly, Pikachu, and Charmander. And if you want to read his name, you can read it. Alright, so that is those. And these are the ones I had doubles of. So Litten and Cutiefly. So I do not know what to do with these ones. Because I can easily see it back up in here. Very easily. But anyway, there we go. Sealed back up. And this is actually sealed. So I don't know whether to do a giveaway of it or save it for years and then sell it. I have no clue. Anyway, here is this little guy. Let's give him room to hop around, shall we? Put those up there. Thank you. I think it's all popped out. That's good. Go put in there. It's very nice. So obviously put these all in the scrapbook thing with the rest of the silhouette things. Because why not? As they say, why not? Okay, so put my sleeves away for now. Let's do this. Then we got the tone dial. A little top heavy. So that is everybody. And while we're on Pokemon, I never made a video of this, but I might as well show you. This is my Eevee from, as you see, Build-A-Bear. It's very nice and fairly firm. And instead of the Pokeball hoodie that I didn't really like, I bought some roses to go in the hair. Besides, they were 5 pounds cheaper anyway. See, just snug on the little band thingy. But yeah, that is my Eevee. I actually bought it in store for a change, but okay. Moving on. Or ending, really. I don't know, I thought the roses suited better than the hoodie thingy. Or the PJs. Not sure. But anyway. Those are that, then with all of these things there, that's, you know, a whole Pokemon party there. So which one of these toys were your favorite? Thank you for watching. I'd like to try for more. Over and out.